before I say anything, this isn't going to be a dig at STEM versus non-STEM degrees. Anything matters, it's all okay. It's more of just me voicing my current frustrations. Frustrations that I have right now because it is currently, 7 a.m.? And you might be thinking, oh wow, did I wake up really early or something? No, it is 7 a.m. because I have currently been working on an assignment for the past 8 hours and I've gotten absolutely nowhere, so instead, I'm just going to rant about it in a video. To set the stage, I'll give the context that this is more for academic stuff, so high school or college level stuff, but let's start off with an example. In high school, one of my assignments were to write a short little essay in the form of a movie review, and at the time, I wrote a review on the movie Deadpool, which I had just recently watched at the time. It was pretty short. It had to be like, 2 pages by hand, I think. Once that was done, I handed it off and thought nothing of it. A couple weeks later, we got our marks back and I was questioned by the teacher because in my review for Deadpool, I was talking about the main character and I wrote that his name was Ryan Gosling, not to be confused with the actual Ryan Reynolds. Now, of course, this is factually wrong. Deadpool was played by Ryan Reynolds, not Ryan Gosling. But for some reason, I had Gosling on my brain, and so I wrote Ryan Gosling. A critical error, but nothing happened. I got a weird calling out for it by my teacher, but at the end of the day, I still got a passing mark, and nothing happened. Now, stuff like this wouldn't pass in things like STEM type of degrees, or STEM modules if you're in high school, for example, math or science and stuff like that. Despite being objectively wrong in what I had said in my English essay, nothing bad had happened. Now, cut to a STEM degree right now, in fact, the assignment that I'm doing. I'll simplify it a bit, but right now, my current task is to essentially make this type of graph visually from a bunch of data that I'm given. Now, what I've actually been doing for the past 7 hours is bang my head against a wall only to come up with this. Now, those of you with a keen eye will notice that these are not the same image. This is not like my Ryan Gosling, Ryan Reynolds mess up. Here, I know that I am wrong. I can see that I am wrong. And I can tell that I am wrong. Right now, right in the moment. And let me tell you, it is incredibly frustrating. This is why, in my opinion at least, these types of degrees, you know, STEM stuff, is a lot more is a lot more frustrating and tedious to deal with. If this were like, okay, I don't want to bash non-STEM stuff, but things that are more subjective are a lot more carefree. Not to say that those things aren't difficult. I can imagine that stuff like art and those types of subjective things are very difficult to get like a good mark. This is the trade-off, I suppose. For example, you could have an art piece that could be the most brilliant thing ever. You think it is the greatest thing ever. 99% of people will think that it is the most amazing piece of artwork they have ever seen. You hand this to your teacher for some reason, because it is such a subjective thing, they say, I don't like it. You're only going to get a 65% or something like that, which is the downside to subjective stuff like that. But on the sort of plus side, in the same vein, they can't really give you a failing mark because at the end of the day, stuff like that is subjective. A teacher can't just say, I don't like it, I'm giving you a fail because somebody somewhere will like it. But in the same vein, they can't just give you a full 100% because what if there are people that don't like it? There probably are going to be people that don't like it. Whereas STEM, it's more of the all or nothing. If somebody gives you an equation and they say, what is, unless that equation is the very specific 9 plus 10, most equations have a very definite answer, a single solution. And if you do not get that solution, you do not get the full marks. In a sense, it's very easy to get full marks if you know the correct answer, but if you don't, well, then you're going to be like me. Stuck, having been awake for the past 8 hours, with absolutely nothing to show. And the best part about this is that this isn't even the final task. This is only halfway through the assignment. I still have more to do in this assessment. This is like that meme where you skip question one in your math test, but question two asks you to use the answer from the previous question. Right now, I'm in that situation. And this assignment is due in about, 3 days now? So of course, naturally, instead of trying to finish this assignment, I'm instead ranting to a video instead. But again, this isn't to try and start a war between STEM versus non-STEM people. I'm pretty sure that non-STEM professions have their own ordeals with this. Like I said, subjective things they have their own issues where no matter how good you think you are, somebody can tell you that it's wrong. But I think that's the reason why I get so annoyed with this right here and now. And why I think many other people also struggle, or not really struggle, but they get frustrated with scenarios like this. Well, this is the internet right now that I'm speaking to. And the one thing that everybody hates on the internet is being told that they are wrong. Even if they are wrong, instead of accepting that, what'll they do? They'll go, oh, pfft, no, you're wrong. No, you're being stupid. No, I'm right. Of course I'm right. You're the stupid one. But in scenarios like this, where there is a definitive answer, it shows you this is what you should be getting. You are not getting that. Therefore, you are wrong. It kind of hurts the self-esteem where you go, maybe I am wrong. The thing that frustrates people the most is that they are indeed wrong. In fact, another funny story coming back to what I started off with. Again, in STEM degrees like this, cheating is very serious, right? You know, plagiarize people's work, you can get in a lot of trouble. But I'm sure, obviously, the same thing happens in non-STEM degrees. The funny thing that I think I got away with, ending the story on a more funny note than, you know, STEM versus non-STEM nonsense, that essay that I wrote, funnily enough, one of my classmates also, for that assignment, wrote about a Deadpool movie review. And the reason why my teacher like pulled me out to mention this issue of me using the wrong Ryan in my movie review is because my close friend, who was watching the movie with me at the time, also wrote Ryan Gosling instead of Ryan Reynolds. So the teacher was pulling us aside because they thought that we were somehow cheating and colluding to copy each other's homework. But it turns out, no, we were just both equally as stupid as each other and made the same dumbass mistake. But the only reason why we didn't get called out for cheating is because, despite us both making the same mistake, we talked about completely different things, which is, I think, again, one of the more beautiful things about non-STEM stuff, right? The subjectivity. If somebody says, can you review this movie? You can write about whatever you want. You can say you loved it, you can say you hated it, you can say why you loved it for different reasons than somebody else who loved it, as opposed to STEM stuff where there is one solution and one solution only, and if you don't get it, then you're wrong. But damn, if I somehow do get this assignment correct, man, will that be really cool. I probably won't though. But that feeling of getting it right, if only. But until next time, bye-bye.